Good morning, students. We are going to start it today. You know, last week we have been discussing with you under the issue of management. We have been discussing the instrument we are dealing with. Basically, we have discussed, we have started to discuss on treasury bill and treasury bonds. So the treasury bill and treasury bonds are issued by Central Bank of Sri Lanka on behalf of the government. So why we issue treasury bill? To attract or to get money from the public to the government. That's the main purpose of issuing treasury bills. So not only Sri Lanka, but all over the world, governments are doing it. All over the world, governments are doing it. Why now? Say, for example, now if the government does not need money, why still the governments are issuing treasury bills? Now, you know, issuing treasury bill or issuing government instrument to the market, they can control many. The government can, or the central banks can control many economic indicators of a particular country. For example, interest rate. Now you know, in Sri Lanka we have two policy rates. Earlier we had a repo rate and reverse repo rate. Now they have changed the name to SDF and SLF. By issuing treasury bill, apart from these two policy rate change, now without changing these two policy rates, they can control the market or the financial sector of liquidity or the interest rate by issuing these types of instruments. So that is another reason why the governments or central bank issuing this type of instrument. For example, if the government is rich with money, what do they want to issue treasury bill? What do they need? Why they want to take money from the public? Sometimes they may not need, but there's still issue. Why? They can control the economic indicators by issuing this type of instrument. Now, for example, you know, treasury bill is a weekly auction based instrument. Every Wednesday you have auction, Friday you have the settlement. Now when the treasury bills are issuing, now see this one. Now we have been discussing with you all this instrument. Remember that 14th July I have uploaded this as well. They have been discussed. Now they wanted to issue on the 14th. They need to issue this much of 56 billion. Now see the results of this particular treasury bill auction. This is the result. Treasury bill auction held on 14. These are the amounts they needed to raise: 15, 23.5, 70. And the bids received. Now you can understand well. Bids received. Government needed to raise for three months, 91. 15 billion, but how much people have put bid? 64. Who are the people? Who are the people can be participate at this auction this day? They have put bids for 3 months or 91 treasury bills. This auction, 64 billion. Can you put a design not full on the? Generally no. Why? Now say this primary dealer has not money. So can they ask withdrawing? Can they tell I don't have money, I won't be able to subscribe, I won't be able to put bids this time, this week treasury bill auction? Can they say that? They can, but the only thing that the government, the central bank will think that this 500 delay is no point of giving a license, no point of continuing the license. Why 10 people have been given the license? If somebody says out of this 10, somebody was telling, I don't have money, I can't put bids. So no point of continuing with the primary deal license with this guy. So they will remove. So basically, entire 10 primary dealers, generally, they put bids. They put bids. So 64 billion they have put. How much they need? Government wanted to raise 15. Now each now Mamadana bid there, Tavakinek Dana, so anybody can put any number of bids, any amount of bids. No issue, no restriction. 15 wanted to raise. Now the finally central bank sort out this how much the number of bids and how much they have received. They have realized 64 billion people have requested for 3 months. How much the government has accepted? 47. Wanted to raise 15. People have, primary dealers have put bids 64. But the government has accepted only 47. More than the requirement, but less than the amount they have received. Why? Now these are the types of questions examiner can test you but never tested. Wanted to raise 15 but government has accepted 47, whereas central bank has received 64. You can see the basis for the result. Last week auction. Now we are talking about 14, right? The auction held on 14. But here the last week, in the sense the week before, right? 7th of July, that week, 3 months treasury bill has accepted by the central bank at 5.19, weighted average. I will tell you why these odd numbers are coming. Now this time, they have slightly increased the rate. People have put, the primary dealers have put bids little higher than the previous week. That's why they have accepted little higher rates. So what does it mean? Now, government has recently, they can't put, now primary dealers can't put whatever the, they can put whatever the amount. They can't put whatever the rate they need. Why? There is a cap. Now earlier there was a cap on 3 months, there was a cap on 6 months, there was a cap. Now still the continuing this cap on 5.1 year, they can't put more than 5.25. And then the bids are anyway, they won't accept. Anyway, it's rejected. Now, even the government has removing this 3 month, 6 month cap rate or the maximum yield rate. You can't put now them. We have mass, we have such a debate, 5.19. You can't put this time 10%. That is market aware. You are not allowed to do that. So after the Aloysius or the perpetual treasury bond scandal, they are monitoring it. They have given some ethics and the rules and ethics you should comply with. So you can't put market away rate. Now may slightly dips 1-2 point, it doesn't matter. But you can't put 10%, you can't put 15%. So then I don't have money, but I don't want to put. But I need to protect my license, then I put bids which are not reliable. 10% of the mama make a gun anymore, the rate. So then I can away from. You can't do that. You can't do it. Make it can you go to the plan? Pahai Panaha and Pulang I can. Pahai Panaha. Part of Pahai Panaha and Jan Nanam, you can put it. That is reasonably okay. Udamana and Pala and if you really need it. you are comfortable with 5.19 or 5%, you can put it with that 5. Now, tell me whose cost is this? Central bank is paying this for investors, in the sense, here the primary dealers. Central bank has to pay. So that anybody who needs to pay something, he has to pay generally. They have a common sense, they should pay less. Mama kaatar deyak pay karanawa nam, mama kaagin har deyak dannawa nam, I should pay higher amount. So I am buying it. So basically, no, the other way around. So if somebody, if I am taking somebody something, so I have to pay lesser amount. If I am selling something, so I have to give more. I am expecting more. Okay, but what then? Rupiah 10 ganna wada wada rupiah 5 ganna ekata laabha mata 5 ganna ekata laabha. So the central, this is the cost of the central bank. This is the cost of the finance, the government. So they need to pay lesser amount. But what happened in the perpetual bond? Market was at 9, people have put 13, they have accepted 13% yield rate as well. So my money, I am individual, my money is investing in the government at 5.25 here, 5.21 here. The last week, the week before, my money was invested at 5.19. Now this week, 5.21. Whose cost has increased? Government of Sri Lanka cost has slightly increased. Who is benefited here? In the primary, in the outset, at the first time, the primary dealers are benefited by 0.02%, 19 minus 21, 0.02%. So their money can be invested at little higher than the previous week. What is the gain they are getting? 0.02%, very negligible, but you can do a lot. Now, what is the indication the government is giving us? That's important. By looking at this result, what's the government giving an indication? What type of indication on the interest rate government is giving us? Going up. Dahaname dibbeka visi ekai. Dahaname dibbeka visi dekai. Visi tune dibbeka visi hatarai. So compared to the previous week, last week, slightly changed. Which side? Upward movement. So what is the indication the government is giving? There is an interest rate increase in future. So the government does not need to adjust policy rates to control the interest. They can do that. Now, for example, say government is accepting, they are not accepting 5, they are accepting for example, instead of 5.21, the weighted average comes after this result is out, 5.18. So what's the indication? Government is not taking high interest rate. They are not expecting to increase interest rate. They never thought. They don't think that in the near future, by 3 months, interest rate will go up. Now here, the what's the indication? Even the shorter tenor, short term, there may be an interest rate increase. So generally, among us also, we have the same thing. Apisthitana, interest rate, langadi udadayi. But this is the lower level of lower regime. So may interest rate 5.21 at 5%, and at AWPLR 5.65%. AWPLR 5.65, so all these interest rates are at lower regime. You can make up what you call this regime is lower level. But a lower level, like there are some band. You can have this 5.19 to 5.3. That is the band. So still we think that we are comfortably at lower level of interest rate. Like that. So they are maybe slightly. In there will be slight increase, decrease, but whatever the band we have, but the general thinking, the people will think that interest rate in the future will go up. So what is the indication of giving that is that And the indication is given by using this, by looking at this special bill auction result. So why the government has accepted more than the requirement? Another question. Why the government has accepted more than the requirement? They need money. Now see, total requirement is 56 billion. But the total amount they have accepted also 56 billion. Which one is different? Only the composition. Composition has changed. Here more than the requirement. Here less than the requirement. Here the worst case. Virtually nothing. 17.5 billion wanted to raise, but only 30 million. See, negligible. Why the government has, or why the central bank has not accepted 1 year bids? If the government needs money, you know, in Sri Lanka, the government needs money, right? Rupee plus dollars, they need money. Why they have not accepted? 17 billion dollars, but now only 30 million only accepted. Why? Even they accepted 30 million, the government has to pay little more than the previous, 5.32. Right? Now, I was discussing with you all. Now, see, this is the result sheet. If you miss this, I will repeat it. But now, previous week, we have discussed this one, the 14th July 2021. This is the requirement, this is the advertisement they have put. And same day after like 2:30 or 3 o'clock, they issue a result. This is the result sheet. Now, what I was telling was, sorry about it, right? 15 wanted to raise. Where do we have this 50? This one, 15, 3 months, 23.5, 6 months. And 1 year, 17.5 billion, 56. Total they needed to raise. Who has to raise? Government of Sri Lanka. Who issues? Central Bank of Sri Lanka. Now see what has happened. This is what has happened. Voted to raise 15 billion, advocated to 50. Now how much they have received? 64 and 47 accepted. So I was discussing these things, right? They have increased the rate, but still they have accepted more than the requirement. And now see this one. Now see, now we were discussing 15 they wanted to raise. 64 people have, or the final dealers have put bid, accepted only 47. More than the requirement, but less than the amount. See, 23.5 billion wanted to raise, but accepted only 8 billion. Whereas they have received bids, 29 billion from the primary dealers, 10 primary dealers. 17.5 billion wanted to raise, received bids, 17.530. But accepted only 30 million. This result, right? Special bill auction, right? 30 million accepted. So, why this has happened? More than the requirement, less than the requirement. But the total amount tallies. 56 wanted to raise, 56 they have accepted. Composition has been changed. Now see, examiner can ask many questions of this, right? This can be asked why this is the government published document. This is not a private, this is public. They can ask questions. They have asked only one question, as I told you last week, from this type and from this. So the individual, can the individual participate at this auction? Generally you can't. Why? Who can be participate? These people can be participate. But if you have more than 5 million rupees with you you can ask one of these primary dealers to put your bid, but whatever the you think your rate. Otherwise, you will have to buy from the these primary dealers. That is which market? Secondary market. Secondary market, you don't get the same rate. This rate, you won't get the same rate. This is the rate given by the central bank to whom? Primary dealers. So the primary dealers also, they are a company. Yeah? They are a company. They need to maintain profit, so they also keep a body margin. Yeah, make it. Yeah, that means usually. But if you put your bid, whatever the your rate, then that's fine. A rate and a problem. There is a problem, right? We have discussed this, right? So the question is, 17.5 billion received, 17.5 billion, 5.3 more than the requirement. They have received slightly, but only accepted 30. Why? But still, see the rate. Rate has increased. The primary dealers have put bids more than the what? More than the previous the week before rate. That is anyway. Why they? Why? That's why the people, the government, central bank has accepted 5.25. But they think after 1 year time. Within 1 year. The mama may sell it. Say now, say if I am a primary dealer. So this 30 million will be invested. We don't know who's this 30. Out of this 10, so this 30 million will be invested for 1 year. 5.24. If you have this 30 million, do you invest now? Generally, you think. Do you invest at 5.24? Why is the other 30 million invest right out of the better? We don't do that. Why is the other again a very low interest rate? So we have another alternative options. So that in investment banking, you will be learning alternative investment opportunities. Why do we need now? See, investment banking is a department or a company. We have a company as well, right? Whose money they are going to control or the manage? Others' money. Or your bank's money. If you are managing others' money, so managing monies which are not owned by you, you need to give whatever the better results to the outside, the money owner. You can charge a fee, that's true. That's a different story. But you should give a better result, better return. So if the FDs are there, fixed deposit, you have the opportunity to put FDs at 6% 1 year. Why do you want to put the 5.24% to in treasury? You don't do that. If you have common sense, you don't do that. You are not investing in treasury bills. Low interest rate, lower than the FD. But by investing in FD, are you carrying a risk? Of course. Do you carry a risk by investing in treasury bills? No. Now see, you are managing others' money. If the money does not pay back, daapu salli hambu netta anunge salli finance company ka daan ahala adna jana ka daan bankrupt kaage salli de me daan ai daan return ek hai salli ham denne disaster amange salli unath hitanne disaster. So you have extra accountability. Why? You are using others' money. You are investing others' money, promising that giving a better return. Right? So you have a utmost responsibility, accountability. Right? So risk wise, yes, special bill is better. But the yield wise, not a good instrument. You need return plus the capital back as well. You need both. High risk, high return. high risk, high return. So that is your call. If you are working in investment banking, are you taking this risk? Apart from this, right? Are you taking by investing in whatever the say ABC company, which is not known to us, not famous to us, but they are paying very attractive interest rate? Are you taking a risk? Yield is pretty good. We can satisfy our investor. Plus, we can charge higher charge fee also from. Are you taking a risk? Second thought is that if the money does not pay back by this particular company, disaster. But we are promising, we have promised investor to give a better return. So, not an easy task, but only thing you have to use your expertise. Right? So, we'll be learning later the diversification. You don't put your entire money in one particular instrument. There are risk-free, there are high risk. Now see, investing in share market. Now if you have made the investment in hotel sector, what is the situation now? You have disaster. Now these days it's slightly going up. That is due to thinking that after September we can open this country for tourism. That is one thing, but if you don't think that like that, so the people who have invested in shares in hotel sector is after. Right? But if you have diversified your investment, portion will be invested in share market, portion will be invested in treasury bill, portion will be invested in a securitization paper, portion will be invested in bond. So you can diversify. But by diversifying also you can eliminate some kind of risk, but you there are some risks which you cannot be eliminated as well. So we'll be learning it, systematic, unsystematic risk later. Unsystematic risk you can avoid, but systematic risk common to everybody, you can't avoid. So by diversification you can avoid. So basically the answer is diversification. So the investment banking and the diversification is go hand in hand, right? Diversification is very important concept for investment banking. Don't put anything risk wise. Now see, treasury bill risk wise perfect view, right? But you have to wait, you have to invest your money for 1 year. Out of the Kanakan, you will be receiving only 5.2. Are you ready for that? That's up to you. So then why people are investing? One thing is primary dealers have to put bids, they have to invest. Now primary dealers la lagati agan na hamathisima me treasury bill auction ekata yanawana. You and I won't invest in treasury bill, that's true. We have a better option. We have another alternative option. But people are there to invest in treasury bill. Who are they? Academy Hamadam option is given weekly. So every this 10 primary dealers may run on make out of the Ganagantiagana, make a Masa Kanagantiagana, make a Masa Kanagana. Ilanga week again, same thing comes. So do they have money like that? They should be money rich then. They don't do that. And recently I want to tell you I'll be giving note on the government or the SEC has, the central bank has increased the capital adequacy of primary dealers. The existing one is 1 billion, now they have increased it to 2 billion. The primary dealers have to be satisfied with 2 billion capital by 31st December 2021. Okay. The next year, by next year they'll have to have 2 billion. I'll be uploading a note on that. I will be giving that additional information which is important for this primary dealers, right? They have increased the capital. The requirement of capital has been increased by the central bank. Right? Now, So they don't do that. There are people who are compulsory investing in treasury bills. Who are they? One thing is the private dealers. They have been given the license to invest. But other than private dealers, they need to sell it in secondary market. Are there any people in there? Now your bank, working in a bank, working in a finance company, go and see your balance sheet. There are portions of investment in treasury bills, treasury bonds. Why? �ස්සර ඉන්වෙස් කරපු කෙනෙකුට කියන්න පුළුවන් at a higher rate. That's true. But go and see the latest investment. There must be latest investment at lower regime of interest rate. මේ කාලෙත් investment සොයා කරන ආගේ බැංකුව. Why? It's a compulsory thing. Now if you take NSD, so the deposit the money has to be, portion of money has to be invested in government treasury bill. That's a compulsory. That's a requirement. But a commercial banks like other than NSB don't have this requirement. Right? 40% has to be invested in government treasury bill, treasury bond by the NSB. Right? But other commercial banks like other banks don't have this requirement. But they do also invest. They do also invest. Why? This is a liquid asset. In my notes, you will be receiving, you must have seen that the features. Highly liquid. Anytime you can sell it. Anytime. So, what do you mean by liquidity? Can be sold without having significant losses. Now, the whole, if I am holding a treasury bill, can I sell that? Yes, of course. There's a readily available market. Can I sell at a profit? That's a different issue. So liquidity is what? You can sell it. You can realize your money. At a profit or loss, that's a different issue. Profit take a gather, loss take a gather, you can make it a different, but you can realize your money. There are people to buy from you as well. Also, so we'll be learning later the relationship between the market yield and the purchase yield. Then in Sri Lanka, I also tell you, in Sri Lanka, in terms of treasury bill, treasury bonds, we go by the rate. What do you mean by that? I have something to sell. මගෙන් තියෙන භාණ්ඩයක් තියෙනවා මම ඒක විකුණන්නේ කර මම ගාන කියන රුපියල් 100යි. කවුරු කෙනෙක් කියලා කියනවා හරි මම රුපියල් 100 ගන්න කැමතියි. ඒතර මම මේක විකුණනවා. මම මේ භාණ්ඩය අරගෙන දින රුපියල් 70ට. Am I making a profit or loss? Of course I am making a 30 rupee profit. හැත්තෑවල ගත්ත එක 100 විකුණනු I'm making 30 rupee profit. Now see this one. I have an investment in treasury bill at 5.5%. Example. I need to sell this. Can I sell it? Yes, you can. Before it gets matured, of course. I have purchased 3 months treasury bill. After 2 months time, I need to sell it. More correct. Sallika disciple. Can I? Yes, you can. What was the rate I have invested in? 5%. I was looking somebody was there. There is a market. I will be telling you how the people can be found. There is two types of, you can either use online Bloomberg, you can use brokers. There are separate share market, okay? There are separate brokers for this government security market. Share brokers are controlled or the managed or the regulated by the SEC. But these money brokers, we call them money brokers. They are controlled or the regulated by Central Bank of Sri Lanka. Right? This is legitimate business. So I tell one of my, the mama individual, I have to tell the primary dealer where I have purchased it. Equitable. මාස දෙකක් ඉවරයි දැන් అనమాట వేసుకున్న కానీ ఇప్పుడు లేదు. What is the rate I have invested? 5%. Somebody was there to buy this particular treasury bill at 6%. So the 5% worth so I am investing 5% worth of my gasti. I mean 6% worth of my illa. Rupees 70 worth of gasti ka CD bill kulu hamo. Obviously I can find out 30 rupees I am selling. 5% on the gateka higher tail leno 6% on the leno. Am I making profit or am I making loss? How do you find out? Percentage pahada gateka higher tail leno percentage 5% on the gateka 6% on the leno. How do I calculate the profit or loss? I can't do that. So then you need to convert this percentages into pricing. Now that's the method Sri Lanka is applying. In India you can see, and USA you can see, they go by the pricing. In Sri Lanka, nominal value of a treasury bill or treasury bond is 100. Nominal value. The option ne kemara ganne rupees 100. But treasury bonds different, right? Accrued interest part is there, don't worry about. CA gatteka 70 vikunona I am making loss. CA gatteka 102 vikunona yes, you are making profit. 5% loss gatteka 6% loss vikunona are you making profit or loss? You can't. Later you can't tell. There is a mechanism to tell. So we'll be learning later the pricing of potential bill treasury bond. But without calculating the pricing, without using the pricing formula, you can straight away tell, you can straight away decide, are you making a profit or loss? So for that we'll be learning later the relationship. We'll be learning the relationship later. By looking at the relationship, 5% you have purchased it, or basically you have invested at 5%, now you are selling at 6%. The relationship is, I'll tell you now, since I have touched this part also, when the yield has gone up, price will come down. Yield ek udade yanakota price should come down. What's the relationship then we have? Negative. Very important relationship. We'll be learning many types of relationships. So we'll be learning the first one when the time comes. The government, in terms of the government equities only, right? The yield and the price has negative relationship. When the yield goes up, price should come down. When the yield comes down, price should go up. 5% will take up taker, 6% will equal. Yield has gone up. Price should come down. High take up taker, hypothetical, I think I have purchased 100. Hypothetical. This is how you think. Power take up taker, higher. CI pricing. Example. How do you find the pricing? I'll be giving a later the pricing formula for you to calculate. එහෙම ෆෝමියුලා එකකට දාපු ප්‍රයිසින් එක අපි හිතන්න බලන්න 100 කියලා එක්සැම්පල්. ඒක 5% වලට ගත්ත එක 100යි. එක්සැම්පල්. Now the this guy is asking at 6%. So the pricing the yield has gone up. So price should come down below 100 or more than 100. 0 ඩ අඩු වෙන්න ඕනද වැඩි වෙන්න ඕනද? අඩු වෙන්න ඕන. Why? Negative relationship. 80යි. 100 ගත්ත එක 80 වෙනකොට is it profitable or loss? So that everybody, your bank, why you have investment in treasury bill, treasury bonds, finance companies, profits. So the lower regime of interest rate is beneficial to whom? People who have invested in treasury bill, treasury bond as well. They need. If the interest rate goes up, they are incurring huge losses. price එක උඩ yield එක උඩ යනවා price එක come down 100 ගත්ත එක දැන් 80යි you have to bring it to the carrying cost every month මේ හැම government security instrument එකක්ම month end එකේ you have to bring it to the carrying value to you market value එකට you have to bring it to record in the balance sheet that's a requirement you have to bring it down basically you have to value at market rate market price so the 80-100 you have purchased now this month prices the yield has gone up the prices have come down 80 now 100 rupees now you have to value at 80 so the 20 rupees is a loss 100 gold I have valued at last month now I am going to value this particular asset at 80 20 is a loss the charge to the P&L loss to the P&L price profit come down profit reduction you're losing so that you don't like interest rate to go up people who have invested in special purpose now see many things you can learn now very important treasury bill interest rate you can decide a lot you can decide the near future 3 months 6 months you can decide the little longer 1 year now see if treasury bill everything will finish within 1 year short term money market instrument short term money market instrument so understand now in this particular one prices the yield has gone up this is percentage now see this is percentage this percentage so I'll be teaching you weighted why this 21 comes why not 20 why this 20 or 25 why this 24 rather than 25 so these are the bits you put in weighted average several people 10 people have put different bits you can put number of bits 3 months වලට ඔයාට එකක් විතර අනිත් අක්කම you have 100 million එක 500 deal එකකට you have 100 million you can break it up to number of transactions 100 නම් 10 million you put at 5.25 another 20 million you put at 5.25 another 30 million you put it at 6% you can have it many but only thing what the central bank is doing is when they receive these bits they sort it out how do they do that the lowest one why they are cost they are paying so they need to pay low amount so they need to select the lower bits yield wise this is my investment mama individual na but this is private dealer's investment the central bank has to pay 5.21 central bank willing to pay 5.21 to 5.19 the generally they like to pay 5.19 for this current option as well but they can't do that why people have put private dealers have put bids at a higher rate so I can save if I would have paid this 5.19 for here this week I would have saved 0.02% for this 47 billion what's the amount the huge amount but I can't do it. So then what does the central bank do central bank is selecting the lower yield aduwema kapuwa for the perpetual bonds can like you one is anitha right so you have selected you are going to select the lower one then you finally arrived at the weighted average I'll show you the example the weighted average that's why I think you have a spot number it doesn't matter right it doesn't matter the only thing you have to identify you have to learn by looking at this the scenario the overall scenario when the government needs this much they have accepted the total amount that's true but only in the composition changes so if the examiner asks you why 17.5 billion they have accepted 30 the primary dealers have put bids 17 billion bits at a higher rate. So the government does not need, government doesn't want to accept this 17 billion or whatever the big amount than this 30 going at a higher yield. No point. And also why the government tell you that they need. But if they accept this, they are giving an indication that the market interest rate will go up. Now here also the same thing signal giving, but only slight change, slight increase that can be tolerable. Okay. Now see, understand this, right? Yes, very well understand. So settlement is 16, Friday. This result sheet is published on the same day you have the option. 14. And after 2-3 whatever, you know whose bids are successful. Who are the primary dealers put bids for 30 million, and who are the successful bidders, and they'll have to make the settlement, they'll have to make the payment. You have slight understanding, right? How this option is happening. Public, the department only the department issues, right? Now see. This is the treasury bond we discussed, right? This is a little comprehensive, but I'll be touching only the requirement part only. And this is the result sheet. I want just to give an idea on the result sheet only here, right? Keep this with you. We'll be using this the next week calculation as well, right? See that this is the result sheet. Again, there is no previous week, this week, no. Why? Treasury bill is a weekly option. Treasury bonds are not weekly thing. On the requirement only government issues. Government take it one on how it right, treasury bond issue for us. I'm a week taking treasury bond issue for not like up my hand. I'm a May bond is a falling issue for the end of the year. Okay. This can be previously issued bond, or the new bond can be new bond. They can have new bond. Now see, this is what's the tenor of this particular bond? What's the period of this particular bond? Date of maturity 2023, or the 2 year bond generally, right? Here. 28 maturity. Now we are in 2021. So then 7 year bond. 2 year bond is you are investing. For 2 years, you are investing your money at how much? Coupon, not the coupon, but the rate. Yield 6.3. Your money is investing. Whose money? Still the primary dealer's money. Investing for 2 years, highest is higher. 7 years, 8.02 volt. So what's the difference between this coupon and this rate? Coupon was not there in the treasury bill. But here you have. So the different instrument. Understand now, this was tested. There is a relationship between coupon and the yield as well. We'll be learning. Coupon means, now take your bank debenture. When they issue a debenture, now commercial bank has issued a debenture, they have published it. once they issue this prospect, I'll show it to you. When they when they issue a debenture, they have coupon rate. You go and see the previous one. Coupon rate is this much: 6 months, 1 year. You can have many options. Now, who decides this? You only decide. Your investment banking people deciding or structuring, basically. Debenture. Debenture issue කරන්න ඕන කියලා requirement එක ආවම, who takes the decision? ALCO, Asset and Liability Management. They are taking a decision to issue a debenture, and who structure this? Investment banking division. Now, for example, now see now we have the private company called Siddhalepa. Now they need to issue debenture. Example, if they need to issue debenture, they're not a finance company, they're not a bank. Why do they issue debenture then? What is the purpose of issuing debenture? To raise money. Similarly, government issuing a similar instrument is what? Treasury bond. So when the government needs money, they issue. When you need money, you issue what? Debenture. That's a simple difference. That's a simple difference. You issue debenture, government should issue. But I have told you the last week, the examiner tested one question. Treasury bonds generally coupon payments are semi-annual. But here you can decide your own way. Semi-annual, annual, monthly, quarterly, you can decide. You have a freedom there. But the examiner's question was generally treasury bonds. Treasury bond issued by whom? Government of Sri Lanka, Central Bank of Sri Lanka, on behalf of the government. But there is another word called private sector companies issuing instrument, corporate bonds. Same thing. Treasury bond, corporate bonds, debenture. Similar instrument. Only the difference is issuer. Treasury bonds are issued by the government of Sri Lanka. Corporate bonds are issued by the private sector company. Debentures are issued by the same. Other than the government. Company can issue a bond, they can have it the debenture, or otherwise they can have it, they can name it as corporate. That's simple, right? So you can have it your own. Now the coupon is what? Now when you invest in this particular debenture, your bank debenture, you can invest. But also we'll be learning another one. You can't invest sometimes your bank debenture. Why? There are instrument we call it Basel III compliant debenture. Now you understand the words only here, right? So you understand the words. So then when we touch the, now once I receive this commercial bank prospect. Prospect is what? When issuing a debenture, you need to tell everything on your bank. To whom? To the outsider. To the people who are expecting to invest in this debenture. You have to tell everything. You know that if you are working in commercial bank of Ceylon here, commercial bank of Ceylon. If you are working in commercial bank, you know what's happening inside. But we don't know. So I have intention to invest in your debenture. Then you should tell the entire information to me. For me to take a decision. How do you tell? How do you say so? What's the document they're using? Prospectus. The prospectus contains everything. Financial, non-financial, litigation, everything. Everything company thinks that the prospective investor should know. Okay. And the prospect. So basically, sometimes I will tell you this one, this clarification as well. Sometimes now the recent past we have seen plans are issuing Basel III compliant debenture. Basel III is what? For your knowledge, I'll tell you the capital adequacy ratio you have to maintain. Now, presently it is 13%. Now, there are two types of banks, systematically important bank, and another one is they have categorized to three sections, systematically important bank, systematically now not important, right? Now, systematically, now the central bank has decided, central bank thinks, systematically important bank, there are two banks in Sri Lanka, systematically important bank. One is Bank of Ceylon, the other one is Commercial Bank. So the, if you are systematically important bank, your capital adequacy ratio has to be higher than the other banks. You should maintain little higher capital adequacy ratio. Why? If something goes wrong with you, Commercial Bank and Bank of Ceylon, so the entire sector collapses. Systematically important banks. There are two banks, right? People's Bank comes to this, the other category. Second category, right? So they need to maintain a lesser capital adequacy ratio than the Bank of Ceylon and People's Bank. Now, we had the capital adequacy ratio to be maintained 14%, but due to this pandemic situation, central bank has reduced it to by 1% to 13%. So I'm telling you the tier 1, tier 2 capital adequacy ratio, right? Entire capital adequacy ratio, tier 2. Right, so the when they issue debenture, generally we have seen many banks are issuing to have this capital. So what are the methods of having capital for a company? These are the question, right? Examiner test. What are the methods of financing for a company? One thing is share issue. Company and share issue one plan when they can. The other one is what? So we'll be learning the impact for share issuing. The other one is what? Right issue. Right issue is for whom? Existing shareholders. Bonus issue? No. Bonus issue is another topic, but only thing, by issuing bonus shares, you don't get money. You don't get money. Right? So we have seen that in terms of shares, new share issues and right issue, you can generate funds for the company. You can generate funds for the company. But say, if now another question examiner tested, why the company has decided to issue shares rather than issuing debenture? Sully owned a company, they can either issue shares. Either new shares or for the existing shareholders, right issue. We'll be learning details, right? I'm just telling you the concept. Or otherwise, apart from this, they can issue debenture. Are there any differences? Of course. Share issue means whom? For the shareholders, the owners. You become owner when you acquire now, say. Now you go and tomorrow you go and buy one share of John Hughes from the secondary market. Share market. When you're dealing with, you're going buying shares from the CSE, Colombo Stock Exchange, meaning secondary market. Why is the private market there? Newly opened company issuing shares to the public, that is primary market. When they issue shares, when they list it, then the secondary market comes, right? You go and buy a share of one share of John Hughes. You become a shareholder there. You are one of the owners of John Hughes. What are your entitlements? You should receive dividends. You should ask to come if it is voting, there are non-voting voting, because if you have budget voting, you have asked, you must be invited to their AGMs. And you can vote it. Even you holding on. Controllable impact. The impact you can make by having one share is negligible. That's true. That's true. But you are still a shareholder. You should receive annual reports. You should receive dividend if they announce it at the AGM. You can vote it. You should have all privileges who are consuming similar to other shareholders. So you are a shareholder, right? Even you're holding one share, right? You can't control it, that's true. Controllable impact has to be very minimal, nothing. But still you are a shareholder, right? So similarly, now see, issuing debentures, issuing shares, many different factors, many different impacts. When you issue shares, you are asking new shareholders to come, new shares. But if you are issuing right issues for the existing shareholders, why do you issue rights issue? Why do you go for right issue rather than issuing new shares? There is a dilution of ownership. ඉන්න අයට ෂෙයාර්ස් දෙන එකද හොඳ අලුතින් මේ අය බලව ගන්න එකද හොඳ then if there is a company performs very well but they need money two options available either issue new shares when you issue new shares you get money that's true company gets money but new shareholders also added අලුතින් shareholders ලත් එනවා Sometimes existing shareholders don't like it. So to avoid that, what's the option? You are issuing rights issue. You are issuing rights. You go for a right issue. For whom? Existing shareholders. At a lower price. We'll be learning later the price examiner frequently tested right issue price in theoretical extract. After the right issue, what will be the price? Theoretical exercise price. We will be learning later when we do shares. I'm giving you the background and the when we doing that, so then you can understand. But now see in investment banking subject, very much live. These things what I'm talking is happening in the market. Happening in the market. There is no theory here. Right issue, is it theory or practical thing? Yeah, it's a practical. Debenture practical. Now banks have started the issue. Bonus issue practical. Dividends practical. Now this if you have made investment, you will be receiving the dividends now. Right? Then you are invited for AGMs now. If you have made some investment in companies, you can vote in. Right? So you become a shareholder. So everything is happening in the real world, but we are learning is very much real. So the government, the company has to decide whether you go for new shares, whether you go for right issue, whether you go for debenture. When you issue debenture, nothing will happen to the shareholding, nothing will happen to the your ownership, but additional liability is created. Why? Debenture. When your bank issue a debenture, your bank has to pay. What do you have to pay? One thing is coupon. Other one is after the maturity, you have to pay the principal as well. So I'm invested. So this commercial bank debenture, okay, I'm going to invest 100,000. 5 years. So after 5 years, I should receive this my 100,000 back, the redeemable instrument, after 5 years. During this 5 year, I should receive coupon interest as well for my investment. So we'll be learning later that types of instruments. There are redeemable, irredeemable, participating. There are many types. But only thing you have to. What do you call certain You have to be certain that money will be paid back and the coupon will be paid on the due date to the investor. That's very important. So it's a liability. Now say when you invest a share, now you to take money, you issue shares. අලුත් ෂෙයාර් ඉෂුව කරලා සල්ලි ගන්නවා කම්පැනිට. That's one method. So the new shareholders comes. New shareholders come to the company. මේ පැත්තෙන් you issue debenture and you take the money to the company. For the shareholders, you pay what? Dividend. For the debenture holder, you pay what? Coupon. For the shares, do you have any maturity? No. When you invest in a shares, when you invest in shares of a company, do you have maturity? You don't. When you invest in debenture, do you have maturity? Of course, if it is redeemable. Generally, we see the redeemable. You just think, yes, that is maturity. 5-year debenture, finish within 5 years. 10-year debenture, finish after 10 years, you have to pay back. But if you invest in shares, do you have maturity? No. There is no maturity for shares. By investing shares, you get dividend plus capital gain. You have a capital gain. Debenture, you have a debenture interest, coupon interest. Can you sell it? Can you sell it? Of course. How? If it is listed. Now, if it is listed, you can sell debentures. Even the shares are not listed, private placement. So in your tutes, the second tutes, the last part is the types of issuing shares. One thing is private placement, the other one is IPO. Still you make private placement, you can sell it. Mama private placement that kala magalaka shares, you know, I can ask somebody, would you like to purchase my share? Then you can sell it. If it is an IPO listed, then the CSE is there. Toronto Stock Exchange is there. Private placement and IPO, two different. Private placement කියලා කියන්නේ මගේ company එකේ මම share issue කරන්න ඕනේ. But I don't want to go public. I don't want to invite everybody to come. I privately tell you, would you like to invest in my share, my company? Would you like to invest in my share, in my company? Would you like to invest? I'm privately talking to people. But IPO is what? You are inviting everybody, all Sri Lankans, all foreigners to participate. Which has high cost. Which has to be given more information through what? Prospector. Right? So the debenture is, you can sell it. Provided that it is being listed. So the listed debentures, are you seeing? Listed debentures, yes, you can. But there is no sophisticated market, debt market in Sri Lanka. You don't have this daily buying selling prices for the debenture, you don't. But still we call, you can, if it is listed, you can sell it, but very difficult. Very difficult for you to sell. And there is no the market, the popular market for debt instrument in Sri Lanka. Even your instrument is listed. Right? Even your instrument is listed. So that's the difference. So it's your call. So now these are the types of questions examiner asks you for 5 months. Text type question. They're giving you a story. There is a company, they need money. One option is to issue shares. One option is issue debenture. So what do you recommend? 5 marks. Simple answer. Simple question. So the same thing they are asking. and many types of question. This is the base for the question. So then if you know by issuing shares, what are the impact? By issuing debenture, what are the impact? So finish. Another question the examiner tested in relation to debenture. Is it worthwhile this company issue debenture under fixed interest rate or floating interest rate? The last thing we touched this floating and fixed. Fixed and floating. Fixed means fixed entire 5 years, provided that this debenture is for 5 years. Entire 5 years, this debenture is, the coupon is fixed. Floating means what? You can have it floating 3 months, floating 6 months, floating 1 year, whatever, it doesn't matter. But you, your reference rate is what? What do you mean by reference rate? Now, I'll show it to you the recently issued debenture, but I have seen in the, okay. There was a recent issue, I'll show it to you the prospectus. The variable interest rate, basically the reference rate is treasury bill rate plus whatever the margin. Treasury bill 6 month treasury bill rate plus 2%. That's a variable interest. Fixed 10% means fixed. How the part of fixed? Here the high gun given me. Either it can be annual, either it can be semi-annual. That is a different issue. But variable means anyway it's changing. 6 month treasury bill plus 2%, meaning every 6 months your interest rate is reset. Why? Every week you have treasury bill option. This rate changes. So the examiner is asking you, will you have taken a decision for working in the investment banking division whether this instrument should issue at floating? This is whether this instrument should issue at variable, whether you allow both options. If I am the outside investor, I like to see the both options, variable, fixed. So then I should decide. I'm the investor, I should decide. But before you issue, you are the issuer, you are the investment banking people, but you expect more from floating, you expect more from fixed, up to your calculation. Now see, you are the investor, you have 1 million rupees with you. You have 1 million. Commercial bank is issuing a debenture now, floating and fixed. They have given the two options, floating and fixed. You have 1 million rupees with you, your savings, your own money. Now you are going to invest in this debenture. Which option you select? You are the investor, right? You are not the issuer. Which option you select? How do you decide? So, namam dekhiye madam. That's not true. Fix uddanu, thought in uddanu. But if you can decide, no, I should go for fixed entire 1 million. I should go for floating. So you have better results. By accepting both options means what? Just while ago we discussed diversification, kind of diversification, risk mitigating. Fixed uddanu, floating uddanu. I'm indifferent. Ekka kala danne mage hama ekam. Kind of diversity. Risk mitigation. So how do you decide? You are an investor. Whether you should select fixed or floating. This is the question. These are the types of questions examiner tests you many times. So these are the questions students ignore to answer. I must also tell you that as well. Now if you just have a look at the past papers, the question number 7 and 8. Lengthy text type question, but if you read them, we all be taking some questions which will want to finish this issue management. So when you read this type of a huge amount of the question, a very lengthy question, but in it, nothing. Just by looking at the amount of words, amount of sentences, students ignore it, but these are the easiest type of questions you can answer, you can easily score. So I always encourage students to answer this question number 7 and 8. The same question, same concept, very small concept. They are giving a story only. Examiner giving the story, but asking question is nothing. Don't skip. The latest examiner report also indicates the least number of questions, least number of students answered questions. So don't do. So when we are doing, I'm encouraging you to do this. When you do the past papers, when you do the questions, we can take that nothing in it, right? Don't ignore this, right? So if you are an investor, I'm giving you the concept, then you won't forget about it. If you are an investor, so you have 1 million given to you, your hard earned money, so where do you invest? Which one you select? Is it floating, fixed? How do you decide? Kumbhal mama decide karan. That's the question. If you have the base for this, you are through. If you have the base for this, entire course is nothing to you. I must assure you. Right? So most of the questions are based on this concept. Most of the questions are based on this concept. Right? Are you selecting a fixed or are you selecting the floating? How do you decide? Your decision is based on the today's context, today's information. Can you predict what will happen after 3 years' time? Can you predict what will happen after 4 years' time? Can you predict what will happen after 2 years' time? Can you predict what will happen after 1 year's time? Moreover, can you predict what will happen tomorrow? Can you happen next few minutes? Can you decide? Can you imagine? You can't. We don't know what will happen. So then you are going to take a decision, 5 year debenture, whether you should go for one fix. Okay. But remember, understand, you take the decision based on today's information. Today, based on current information. Other than information, Madatama, you take a decision for your 5 years. Can it be wrong? Of course. If you have taken a decision in 2019, were you expected Corona? Were you made any provision for Corona? Did you have any intention that your export income has come down drastically? Were you expected import restriction? Were you expected the car importation restriction? None of these. But it happened. Your budget, your banks, your company's budget was based on 2019 December figures. But can you achieve? So basically, we have prepared everything, we have done everything based on the today's information. Today's information can be changed, yes, of course. But there should be a base for us to take decisions. There should be a base for us to take decisions. based on today's information, what kind of interest rate regime we are working on or we are living in? Low regime of interest rate. If you have 1 million rupees, there are 1 million rupees. Forget about the debenture investment. Do you go for short-term investment or long-term investment? Think about FD. Do you invest 3 months? Do you invest 1 year? Or do you invest 5 years? Now, you have now invest 1 million rupees. You have to take the decision. Generally, you go for what? Short-term. Why? Do you block your investment 5 years now? I don't think any rational investor doing it. Then what is the problem? Is the interest rate of doing? Is it worthwhile for me to block for my investment 5 years? Correct. Sir, had it interest rate adwena na, you should block your investment for longer term. True, but you are blocking your investment now. Presently, we are at a low regime of interest rate. If there is low interest rate, then you are blocking for 5 years. It is not recommended. Have a main interest rate adwena digatama dibena, you can make losses. Interest rate fallenata awa, you can make losses. Aparadha mate denapula ayyo aparadhe, I would have blocked my investment for 5 years. But today we are taking a decision based on today's situation. So decision is what? Are we blocking my investment for 5 years at a lower regime, lowest regime of interest? Make 12, 13 wage dipana for me to block for 5 years, that's fine. Now today we are giving, today the banks are giving 7% maximum for 5 years. Are you looking for 5 years? At 7%? So what's the treasury bond for 5 year treasury bond? 7.3 for 5 year treasury bonds. So the banks are paying generally 7.5% like 5 years. So are you looking your investment for 5 years at 7.5%? I don't think so. So generally you think that I should go for short term. There may be after 3 months time, there may be interest rate downward, that's true, so true. Another 3 months time, again came down. But one day there is an indication given by the government, there is a tendency interest rate to go up. So then the wise investor, the rational investor will go for shorter tenor investment, short term investment, short term investment. So that is you invest, you have option of investing treasury bond. No, I'm sorry, the FD. Now take this example, debenture one. Are you going for floating or fixed? When you go for fixed, meaning what? Do you think interest rate in the future will not go? What do you mean by that? Is there the interest rate take a adunat vadunat? If you have invested in fixed, you are indifferent. 10% you are in, say for example the debenture is paying 1 year fixed rate 10%. Now the out the reserve pass the interest rate take another 12%, 13%. Similar instruments are issuing 1 year coupon rate is 12%. Can you do anything? You can't do anything. You can tell it, that's true. But you have to think about like this, aparadhamang initially, fix it, 10%, whereas similar instruments are paying 12%. You can't do anything, why? You have selected fixed. You have selected floating. The decision is based on, in the future interest rate tendency is to go up, then you go for floating. That's the base. Why? Every 6 months I shall be right, plus whatever the month, every 6 months interest rate is reset. when the market interest rates have gone up by that time, you are having a higher interest rate. 6 month treasury bill rate plus 2%, other 6 month treasury bill like 5%, you are getting 7% through mass higher. Have a mass higher level of treasury bill rate take given on at 8 plus 2, margin won't change. 8 plus 2, 10. For the next 6 months, you are getting 10%. So the your decision is based on what? Future interest rate. So how do you decide future interest rate to go up or come down? There is a concept called, we'll be learning later, yield curve. Everybody has to, generally the investors are drawing the yield curve. Treasury bill and treasury bond rates ekada aragena they draw a yield, they draw a what do you call this graph called yield curve. There are four types of yield curve. I'll be up next to you is also on that, so you can have this. So only thing what I want to give you is your decision is investing in treasury bill, treasury bond are based on what? Treasury bill, treasury bond based on the float, whether you select floating or fixed, based on what? You have to select what? Based on the current interest rate scenario and the future interest rate scenario. The now you know based on which we select, based on the yield curve. All the background that I have created for you to think, to come to this particular word, yield curve. So then somebody asks you, are you selecting fixed rate? Are you selecting floating? How do you decide based on the yield curve? Simple answer is that. Isra the interest rate, where do you know then I should select Isra the interest rate, or you know then floating, you can reset, you know, everything is fine. Everything has to be considered when you're doing this yield curve. So your answer should be one word, yield curve. So that's what I want to tell you. Now in this tilt, now see the tilt I have given to you, I have included everything. Only thing I will not taking each and every tilt with you, but it contains everything, right? Now this one I have displayed. Treasury bill is explained. Now this liquid asset, right? I'm sorry, the liquid asset. Zero coupon. There is no coupon. Anytime money market instrument, and also giving the features of this liquid asset. Face value and everything. So don't worry about this wording. We will be dealing when we're doing this. Treasury bonds with you, par, discount, premium, those are new words, but very easy to understand. Here got the cost of discount. Here got the category come premium. What is this here? That is in Sri Lanka, the nominal value of a treasury bill, treasury bond. Simple. If Krish asked, we have touched it. The finally, I have discussed with you this part, right? I have touched this part as well. You place in public before like that. The change shares, but we have not touched the shares yet. The only thing where we are holding this treasury bill. So any question you have, only thing I just wanted to give you fair knowledge on you, fair knowledge to you, so then you can understand well. I can do it a little faster, but only thing I think that giving a knowledge to you, then you won't forget about it, because we are actually dealing with the what do you call this